Next question on the order paper is from Assembly Member Berry and relates to First Dibs for Londoners.
Thank you. New homes should help Londoners rent or buy a home, and City Hall's policies to build more social rented and other genuinely affordable homes are clearly key to this. But more widely, we want more open market homes, particularly at those that are relatively less expensive, to help Londoners too. That's where First Dibs originated. Our current approach to First Dibs is based on a voluntary offer made by over 40 home builders, including the G15 housing associations and members of the Home Builders Federation, in February 2018. This offer restricts sales and marketing of new build homes up to £350,000 to UK buyers for the first 3 months, with a head start of up to 1 month, during which only Londoners can buy them. They must be advertised on my Homes for Londoners portal. It also commits home builders advertising help to buy homes in my portal. Help to buy homes must be owner occupied and cannot be second homes, so they can only be bought by people who are or want to become Londoners. My team are using the portal to monitor the First Dibs offer. It is only a snapshot in time, but right now there are three developments on the portal in Ealing, Waltham Forest and Newham that include properties for open market sale below £350,000, and 73 developments that include help to buy homes. Developments including First Dibs homes started to go on the portal in late summer last year. My team's monitoring shows that across developments advertised so far, there have been 23 homes under £350,000 and over 1,000 homes advertised for help to buy. Through my team's forward monitoring, we know of a further 184 First Dibs homes that will be on the portal soon, and my team will keep a record when they do. Further down the line, my team will also look at land registry and other data to monitor whether First Dibs is helping Londoners to be the ultimate buyers of more homes. All this information will feed into a review of the voluntary First Dibs offer next year. I accepted a voluntary offer from the industry as it was able to deliver immediately for Londoners, whereas using planning measures would take years for them to be adopted and have an effect. However, we need to make sure the current approach is effective. Using my team's monitoring information and other data, next year's review will assess whether the voluntary offer is going far enough. Depending on the outcome of that review, all options are on the table, including looking again at using planning powers to achieve my goal and urging ministers to change the law.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I mean, it is disappointing you don't have data on the sales so far to show us today. As I understand it, the key difference between this and the previous mayor's basically ineffective concordat policy with developers is that your agreement limits actual sales to be for Londoners for 1 month and then UK residents for a further 3 months, while the previous mayor's concordat was just about marketing homes. So you should be able to monitor more or less in real time off the land registry what's going on, and it seems to have started in February. So I'm very disappointed you're not giving us any more numbers on the sales and whether the proportion is actually changing. Do you have any idea about that?
So your assessment of the difference between this and the concordant is not quite right. So we require, as a consequence of the deal we've got, all the properties go through the portal. So previously what happened was they'd be marketed in London at the same time as marketed elsewhere, but also not through one system. So you'd have to turn up at various places, and we weren't sure how they would be marketing. This scheme means they come to London first before being marketed, let alone sold elsewhere, but through the portal. So it's a way of you as a potential, somebody wants to buy in London as a Londoner, you know where they're being marketed and where they'll eventually be sold. And we know the numbers of people registered on the portal. I think the number for numbers registered is, 24,000. We also 22,000 registered users, but also we know more than 230,000 people have used the portal so far. So we know people are using the portal. We know this is the way that the developers are agreeing to market. And so once we've got sufficient, we think 2 years is sufficient information to see the sales.
Yeah, sorry to interrupt, but I mean, I'm looking at the press release that was put out when you launched the agreement, and you said that you called it a landmark, and you said that this was the first time you'd got promises about sales rather than just marketing.
Sales. So it is. Yeah, you can't. That. Yeah, 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 you can't. Yeah, yeah.
So if
Boris
Johnson
was just marketing, yeah. This is selling.
So that's what I said at the beginning. I want to ask about the website particularly, because obviously that was part of the policy announcement, and the website is up and running now. I've been monitoring it. I'm on it now. There don't seem to be any... The First Dibs part of your website says go here and search, but there's no choice of searching for First Dibs homes. And the adverts for private sale homes don't say, these are for Londoners now, get in there before the month is up. There's nothing there about First Dibs, so that's quite confusing. The numbers also don't seem very high. I mean, you said there were 23 homes so far since the
first Dibs is,
the
First
summer.
Dibs is, they're only available on the website in London for the first month.
But it doesn't say only Londoners or UK residents can buy them. There's no restriction.
But we know the registered users are, they're Londoners.
So it's only for the registered users?
For the first month, they can only be sold to a Londoner. After the month two and month three, they're Londoners plus the rest of UK in advance of their being marketed or sold elsewhere. What's happened previously was they are being marketed only, not sell, in London at the same time as elsewhere around the world. So what's happened as a consequence of our policy and agreement is Londoners have a head start to the rest of the country. The UK has a head start by 3 months to the rest of the world.
Okay, great. Last night I looked, there were no homes when I looked for private sale homes under £350,000. Today there are three that seem to have gone up this morning. There are three adverts. That doesn't seem very many. Can we get a week-by-week breakdown of what's been advertised on the site so far?
No. The reason, one of the reasons why there will be fewer, there'll be few below 350 is because there are so few with the 40 developers we've got to deal with who are producing the market properties of £350,000. One of the reasons why we chose 350 was because you have a salary, roughly speaking, 90,000 to be able to afford a property of £350,000. You'll be aware the research we did in 2016 showed that half the properties bought by overseas buyers of properties for £500,000 or less. That's why we were concerned.
Yeah, but there's very few homes at that price. That's the point.
No, sure,
that's why I'm asking for the week by week breakdown. I want to see what's actually going on.
Sure,
there.
But don't forget that the developers we have a deal with, G15 as well, are also producing homes for rent, part of the genuinely affordable homes. So on average, 38% are going to be affordable rent. So they won't be there because they're for rent and they're allocated by the
The thing is, I'm just trying to keep a track of this First Dibs policy. It was an absolute mantra of yours in the 2016 election. Every time housing came up, you were there saying, First Dibs for Londoners, gold bricks. We do need to be able to get the monitoring of this as soon as possible. Your review, it'll be out before the next election so that we can hold you to account.
But it's really important.
Ideally, because my colleague is...
I know one of the advantages of being a politician for the Green Party, you don't rely upon the facts, but the facts are we can't force developers to do anything.
I just want to know if your review will be out before the next election.
And I just want you to know the facts. And what's really important is I use...
You're going to have to stop. I'm sorry, Mr. Mayor. If your review doesn't come out before the next election, we'll be... having words.